Basically, what I'm trying to say is, from where I'm sitting, a sub $300 smartphone might well be the worst use of your hard-earned money. Okay, so if you want to buy cell phones these days, there are so many options, especially the sub $300 smartphone range comes with so many phones that seem to give you so many features that you wonder, should you even spend more money on a phone? Take for instance the Xiaomi Mi 11 Lite. It's a $300 smartphone that has a high refresh rate display, comes with a 4250 milliampere battery with 33 watts fast charging, 128 gigs of internal storage, 8 gigs of RAM, a Snapdragon 732G, which is a pretty decent processor that actually sips power, so it gives you more battery life. It seems like it's a fantastic package. But really, if we're assessing value, which is what we're doing at the budget end of the range, you can only get a really good idea if you start comparing phones. So in this video, I'm going to make three unfavorable comparisons and you'll see why. Our first comparison is going to be the Xiaomi Mi 11 Lite versus this guy. I should probably make him seem a little nicer. Okay, this guy. The OnePlus 6T, my daily driver for the past 3 and something years. This is a phone that was a premium mid-ranger, but it's 3 years old, so it should be completely blown out of the water by anything you get this year, right? Let's find out. For starters, it comes with an AMOLED 1080p display that is only 60 Hz. We've gotten to the point where we're calling AMOLED 1080p displays only. But the point is, the Xiaomi Mi 11 Lite comes with a 90 Hz refresh rate. In my book, that's not a big deal because 90 Hz versus 60 Hz, you'll only see the difference if you're absolutely looking for it. It doesn't jump out at you like those higher refresh rate displays do. So yes, the Xiaomi is a bit better, but not by much. Now the Xiaomi also has a bigger battery and faster charging. This one's got 3700 milliampere with an 18 watt fast charger, whereas the Xiaomi Mi 11 Lite comes with a 33 watt fast charger for a 4250 milliampere battery. So it's better in that respect as well. Mono speaker, Xiaomi comes with dual speakers. So far it's looking like the Xiaomi is pulling ahead quite well. But when we look deeper, when we dig into it a little bit, we see that this guy comes with a Snapdragon 845. Which absolutely blows the Snapdragon 732G out of the water. 3-year-old phone is still able to give you more power than a brand new phone. And to top it all these components are packed together in a shell that was made for $600, which means this is a glass sandwich design with an aluminium frame as opposed to the Xiaomi, which is plastic. Oh, and this is Gorilla Glass 6 versus the Xiaomi's Gorilla Glass 5. Which I didn't expect, but really doesn't make that much of a difference. So I guess it looks like this comparison wasn't quite as unfavorable as we'd thought, and that the Xiaomi, the $300 champion phone from today, is still only trading blows from a premium mid-ranger from 3 years ago. And if I flip that around, it kind of means that if you buy a premium mid-ranger today, it's going to still be relevant 3 years from now and is still going to go on for longer, which means you won't have to buy a newer phone. But you might say, okay, I don't buy new phones that often anyway. I take care of my phones. Plus, I'm not going to buy a 3-year-old phone just because it's slightly better in some ways. That's fair. So let's move on to our next two unfavorable comparisons. This time, it's going to be unfavorable to the Mi 11 Lite out and out. I'm going to compare it with last year's premium mid-rangers, the Xiaomi 10T for a Xiaomi to Xiaomi comparison, and the OnePlus 8T since there are other phones of OnePlus, but really you can use any mid-ranger for this example. Now, both the premium mid-ranger phones come with proper high refresh rate displays. The Xiaomi Mi 10T comes with a 144 Hz display and the OnePlus 8T comes with a 120 Hz display. Now that is proper high refresh rate. Plus they both come with great batteries as well. The Xiaomi Mi 10T actually comes with a 5000 milliampere battery with 33 watt fast charging, but the OnePlus 8T comes with a 4500 milliampere battery with 65 watt fast charging. They both come with dual speakers. Everything else is kind of similar until you get to the internals, where both of them are rocking Snapdragon 865s, which is understandable for the price range they were marketed at. To go one step ahead, UFS 3.0 as opposed to 2.1, which means faster internal storage, and the OnePlus 8T also comes with USB-C 3.0, which means faster data transfers. So far, everything seems to be better in the premium mid-ranger. Not really a shocker. Obviously, they're also made for the $600 price point, so they come with all glass and aluminium constructions. That's a given. Now, you might be thinking, okay, but what is the point of this comparison? Obviously, they're going to be better. They're $600, except they're not. Right now, both of my premium mid-ranger phones I've taken as an example are available at $350 to $400 on Amazon. And this happens every single year. If you look at last year's premium mid-rangers, they give you pretty much all the performance you can get out of a phone without jumping to that $800+ price bracket, but they're also discounted to around $400 a year later. And if you really look for a good deal, you can get it under $400. So tell me again why you would buy the $300 smartphone. Now, I understand that some people don't have a choice. Some people can only spend $200 to $300 and they need a phone right now. Like, they can't wait. If you're one of those people, I completely understand and I get it. I do. All I'm saying is, if you're not in that situation, if you can afford to wait even a little bit longer and save up money to get to that $400 price point, and if you don't mind going for last year's model, then you get something that gives you both the feature set and the quality of a much better phone with a performance that far outruns anything from the $300 smartphone range, which also means you get a phone that stays relevant for longer, which also means that you don't have to buy a new phone every 2-3 years. You can wait a little bit longer because you still got a good phone. Basically, what I'm trying to say is, from where I'm sitting, a sub $300 smartphone might well be the worst use of your hard-earned money.